320 miles northwest of Dutch Harbor, Captain Rick Faist of the Early Dawn has dialed into a heavy Opelio biomass.
We are so in the meat pile here. The crab are stopping at a certain depth. They're actually stopping, they won't go any deeper. You know, you're approaching a cliff, basically what's right over here.
Rick's gambled a carpet bomb all 110 of his pots on the edge of the cliff is paying off.
Going right into that corner, and they will pile up. This is what drives us to be out here. Woo! The excitement, the thrill.
Love it!
For Opies, Rick's hired a new greenhorn, Ian Thomas, Brian's first cousin.
Well, I'm the bait guy. Basically, I gotta keep ahead of the pots as they come over. Yeah. Always have bait to rebait the pots.
Greenhorn Ian is kicking butt here, taking his bait to the fullest limit. He's the man that baited these pots to get this 800 crab per pot.
That's it. Yeah.
He's staying on top of everything. Couldn't ask for a better bait boy. Good job, Ian.
Woo. Just doing what I do, Daddy.
And you're helping out, making the chief's job easier, making my job easier, any of the other guys. And you're definitely in good grace.
Ian's status as low man on the totem pole pushes Brian up the ladder from greenhorn to full share, a quick climb after just 5 months on the boat.
His dad owns the company. He has a lot of opportunities.
I learned it all before, and I've done it all before, but I'm just getting more time on it now, getting better at it.
After averaging solid 800s, Rick pulls a goose egg.
Nothing.
But the crew discovers that the door wasn't secured properly.
Tie that thing.
Door's wide open.
You know, that pot would have came up with 500-600 crab.
12 hours ago, Brian set a pot without firmly tying down the door. Any crab that managed to crawl in took the bait and crawled right back out.
Every time you make that mistake, that's $1,000 mistake.
Every time that happens, that's $1,000.
Move a half share move. Kill me. Guy on the back side of the pot forgot to shut the door.
As usual, Brian refuses to take responsibility for the mistake.
Won't catch any crab without the door being shut.
It's a whole different scenario with the owner's kid on board. Yeah, it puts all of us in a bad situation. I'm trying to make it work.
Brian's lack of ownership is enough to motivate engineer Mike Fish to begin training the other heir apparent, Ian.
Brian likes to tell everybody what to do, but he won't get in and do it. Now I have Ian, his cousin, who wants to get out of the bait bin and take over Brian's position. He's like, give me his percentage. I'll do whatever you tell me. I'll make sure it's done. So it's like, I'm ready to do it. You know, when you have one guy that wants to take over his father's boat, for him to earn any respect, he has to do the job also. You wanted it, now you have to do the work to earn it. Otherwise, we'll put another guy in there that wants to do it.